Hi everyone, welcome back to GK Code Labs. Today I'll take you through Hive UDFs, a very small discussion about what are Hive UDFs and how to create one using Scala and SBT. Hive UDFs is a very important topic when it comes to big data interviews, and it also increases your productivity if you know how to create a Hive UDF using any one of Scala, Java or Python. So in this video, we'll also see how to create a Hive UDF using Scala and use that same custom code to query on any of our Hive tables. So let's have a small discussion on what are Hive UDFs. We already know some of the built-in functions like concat, length, lower. So here if you see, these are the predefined Hive functions. Like if you want to concatenate two or three strings like Hadoop hyphen Hive, the concat is an inbuilt function in Hive that takes a number of strings and returns a single string with concatenated values. Similarly, length is another Hive inbuilt function, and as the name suggests, whatever string you pass to it, it will give you a length. So similar way, there are number of built-in functions that are already available to you when it comes to querying on your Hive tables. But what if you have some specific requirement? Like for example, if you have some specific requirement, I'm not going into details, but suppose you do not need these inbuilt functions. You need some other functions, let's say GK Code Labs. And if you pass any string to it, you expect some output like user underscore arpit or anything it could be. So these are the custom requirements that differ people to people and user to user. So for this kind of requirements, Hive provides us user defined functions where we can write our custom code and use that in a similar way that we use Hive built-in functions. So let's take an overview. What are the steps that we need to take if we have any such custom requirement and we need to create a Hive UDF? So as in this tutorial, we'll be coding everything in Scala. So first step would be we'll create a Scala class. Then we have to use a specific jar file, hive.exec, followed by whatever current version of hive.exec is there that supports our current Hive version. This jar we have to use in our Scala program. And once you use this jar in your Scala program, you will be able to extend and override this evaluate method, which is present in this Hive exec jar. You can use this jar in either Scala, Java, or whatever programming language you are using. You have to use this Hive exec jar if you want to code a Hive custom UDF. If it is still not clear to you, do not panic. I will code everything from scratch so that you will be clear on this. Then we can write our custom code, whatever requirement we have, in this overridden evaluate method. Then once we have our class ready, we can build the Scala code into a jar file. And then simply we can create a custom function in Hive using this jar. So this was just an overview, or you can say stepwise plan that we are going to follow now. So now let's start coding a custom Hive UDF in Scala. So I will switch to my VM. For a change, I am using Ubuntu 18.04. I just wanted to use the latest version of Hadoop and Hive. As you know, in Cloudera Quick Start VM, we don't have the latest version. So that is why I set up this Ubuntu virtual machine. So let's fire up the IntelliJ IDEA. Let's also check if all our Hadoop daemons are running. So, okay, nothing is running as of now. I'll start my Hadoop and yarn. Okay, so our name node, data node, everything is running. So now we are good to work on Hive. Let me show you the version of Hive I'm using. So you can see here, I'm using the latest version 3.1.1. So let's come back to our IntelliJ. We'll create a new project that will be Scala and SBT. Next, let's name it Hive UDF GK. JDK version is 1.8. Just click on finish. Let's give it some time to sync and let the project be ready to code. Okay, so SBT project is ready. This is our source directory, main, test. So now the first thing, let's create a Scala class. Let's name it GK UDF test. Now the second important thing I told we have to import hivexec.jar. So there are two ways you can use this jar. Either you can download it from the online repositories, or the other simple way is, if you have Hive installed, obviously you will have it. That's why you are creating the UDF. You can get the same version of hivexec jar in the Hive lib folder. I'll show you. So here is my Hive installed. You can go inside this lib, and inside this, it's very complicated. Let me open this in terminal. If you can see, I'll list. You can see in the Hive build itself, in lib folder, you will see hivexec 3.1.1. I'll suggest you to use this one, because if you use this, you don't need to take care about the correct and compatible version, because you are taking it from the lib folder of same Hive build itself. So this is the jar that we have to use in our code. Let's go back to our IntelliJ. Now, to use that jar, first step, go to your build.sbt and you can write unmanaged jars in compile plus equal to the file and the file path. We have the file path here. Slash the file name. So this will prompt you to import the changes. Just click on import changes and wait for some time. Now it's done. Now let's go and write our custom code. Also, we have to build this, so let's follow the proper folder structure. We'll create a package inside this. Let's name it com.gkcodelabs. And let's move this class inside the package. Okay, so done. Now we'll write import org apache hadoop hive ql exec and udf. Now the same library you need to extend in your class, udf function of this hive. Now let's create a evaluate method. Now let us have a specific requirement. Let's see any of the table. Okay, I have already created one small table here. So it has three columns: month, day, and year. So values are like this, you can see. Month is January, day is Sunday, year is 2019. So we have two values. So suppose we have a specific requirement that we do not need complete names of month and day. We just need first three characters. Actually, there is a substring function that is inbuilt in Hive also. For this tutorial, let us take, we have a special requirement where we need to take only first three characters. So let us build a user defined function which can do that. So when you are overriding the evaluate method, you must know that if you call your user defined function, it will pass the value of that column into that UDF. So first thing, we know that our evaluate method has to take one argument that will be as a string. Let's say str, which will be string, and also it will return a string that will be the three characters that we decided, the first three characters. So it will take one argument that will be complete word, and it will return three characters. So again, it will return a string. So let's define a return type also that will be string. So this can be our body of evaluate method as per our requirement. Now what we have to do, we have to take this string str and do a substring here. Sorry, this will be caps. Do a substring from first character, that is 0th element, till the third element. So that is overall that we have to return. Let's assign this to a val. You can say return string and then return red str. So I hope this is clear to you. Let's also check the null as well. If str is null, then you can simply return null. So this completes our simple code. Now this code is ready to be packaged into a jar so that we can use it with Hive. So for building this jar, we'll be using SBT assembly. To add SBT assembly to your project, create a new file under your project directory. New file with the name plugins.sbt. And inside this, you have to include a string add SBT plugin. This is the repository, and SBT assembly can be downloaded. The version I'm using the latest, if you can see the SBT assembly, the latest version is 0.14.9. So I'll mention the same here. I'll mention this string in the description below. So just go inside your plugins.sbt and paste it and import changes. So let's complete it. So let's go ahead and build this project. Go to the main root directory of your project. Let's open this in terminal. And simply on the root directory, we can initiate the command SBT assembly. It will analyze the SBT folder structure and create your jar file. So here you can see you'll get a success message, and once you get this success message, you can open your target folder. Inside target, Scala, and you will see your jar file created. Now let's take this jar file. I'll open this in files and let's copy it to our desktop or any place you want. So this is our jar file, UDF jar file. Let's open our Hive session, choose any database. Here we have our table. Now first thing you need to do is add this particular jar into our Hive class path. Let's copy the location. And the command to add jar is simple, add jar and the path of the jar file. Let's mention the same name of the jar file. And that's it. You can see you'll get the message added resources. So this particular jar is now added to Hive class path. Now we have to create a function that uses this jar. Let's create a function. Create function. Any custom name, you can mention GK custom substring. And now you have to mention the class name after as keyword. The class name would be your package followed by your class name. So what is our package name? Package name is com.gkcodelabs. This is our package name followed by our class name. Class name is gkudftest. Now hit enter. You can see you will get the message OK. Now if you select month column, select month from udftest, you will get January and February. And we have created our custom UDF to extract first three letters. So if you use our custom UDF name, GK custom sub along with this column name, you can see we are getting only first three letters. That is, the January is feeding into the input, which is str, and it is not null. So finally, we are taking a substring to first three characters and returning it. And same function is used in our Hive UDF. You can use it in any particular column. Suppose I mentioned day here, you can see SUN and MON. If you don't use it, you'll get the exact value. So this is how you can create a custom UDF for any of your particular requirement and use it along with your Hive. So guys, if you liked this video, please hit that like button and please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. Also mention if you have any confusion in Hive UDF creation using Scala and SBT. Thank you guys, see you later.